Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. For those who are sitting in the back, I would like to remind you that alhamdulillah, new carpet has arrived. In order for us to feel the new carpet freshness, I would like you to be in the front row, alhamdulillah, as it was also the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to be as close as possible, because this place gets busy later on with the people that come late. More importantly, please make sure that your phones are absolutely silent, more so that you have full tarkeez and concentration to the khutbah. Barakallahu feek. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له جل عن الشبيه والمثيل والكفي والند والنظير وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله وخيرته من خلقه وأمينه على وحيه أرسله ربه رحمة للعالمين وحجة على العباد أجمعين فهدى الله تعالى به من الضلالة وبصر به من الجهالة وكثر به بعد القلة وأغنى به بعد العيلة ولم به بعد الشتات وأمن به بعد الخوف فصلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله الطيبين وأصحابه الغر الميامين ما انتصرت عين بنظر ووعت أذن بخبر وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد أيها الإخوة الكرام أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله في السر والعلن فإن الله جل وعلا أمرنا بتقوى كما جاء في سورة آل عمران يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وفي بداية سورة النساء يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا وفي نهاية سورة الأحزاب يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وخير الهدى هدى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أعاذنا الله منها جميعا My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, in the last 3-4 Fridays we have been through some of the minor signs, rather most of the minor signs of the hour, meaning the Qiyamah. We started with something that has been already passed. One of that was the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Other was the inshiqaq of al-qamar, the splitting of the moon into two, and so on and so forth. In the middle part, we have been through some of the things that already passed, but some of that will also happen. Meaning, claiming prophethood, meaning false prophethood that we saw from the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or even before the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, until this time. Inshallah, this part we will go through some of the things that are about to happen or will happen in the future. A hadith, this is recorded in the Sahih al-Bukhari. It is narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, the one who memorized or narrated most of the hadith. In terms of those who narrated the hadith, Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu comes on the top, even more than Ummul Mu'mineen Aisha bint Abi Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anha. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu said that while the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was in a gathering, in a majlis, speaking to the people, a Bedouin came and asked, "Mata sa'ah, when is the hour?" Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam continued to speak. So that some of the people said that he, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, maybe heard but disliked or did not like what the Bedouin asked. Others said to the contrary, he didn't hear, meaning the Bedouin, the way that he was so far away, because of that, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam could not hear what the Bedouin asked. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam finished speaking, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam asked about the Bedouin, the questionnaire. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he called him, he said, "Labbaik ya Rasulullah." Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said about the question, "What was your question?" He asked, "Mata sa'a?" Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said in response to his question, "Fa'in duyya'ati al-amanah fantadhir as-sa'a." When the trust or the amanah will be lost, then wait for the hour. Can I ask you, please close the door? The Bedouin asked, "Ya Rasulullah, and how will it be lost?" Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Idha wussid al-amr ila ghayri ahlihi fantadhir as-sa'ah." When the affair or the leadership will be entrusted to those who do not deserve it, who is not worthy of the leadership, that is the time you should wait for the hour. You would also see the weakening of the Muslim nation. Thawwab radiallahu anhu narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Yushiku an tada'a alaykum al-umam min kulli ufuqin kama tada'a al-akalatu ila qas'atiha." Very soon, the nation will call each other upon you from all the horizons, meaning from all the directions, north, east, south, west, whatever the directions that we have, just as those who are dining call each other to their dish. Thawwab radiallahu anhu said, we asked, "Ya Rasulullah, will that be because we all will be very few in number?" Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in response to the question of the narrator Thawwab radiallahu anhu, "Antum kathirun walakin takununa gutha'un ka gutha'is sayf tuntaza'u al-mahabatu min qulubi aduwikum wa yaj'alu fi qulubikum al-wahm." No, rather at the time you will be many, but you will be gutha, like the gutha, meaning the scum that gathers on the surface of water, the dirt that gathers on the surface of water in the sea. Fear and awe of you will be removed from the hearts of your enemies, meaning the enemies will have no fear whatsoever. And al-wahan will be cast into your hearts. The Sahaba radiallahu anhu ajma'in asked, "And what is al-wahan?" Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in response to this, "حُبُّ الْحَيَاةِ وَكَرَاهِيَّةُ الْمَوْمُوتِ." Love for the life and the hate for the death. This hadith recorded in Musnad Imam Ahmad. Abu Dawood rahmatullahi alayhi also narrated this. Abu Na'im in Al-Hilya, he narrated this. And Sheikh Nasruddin Al-Albani rahmatullahi alayhi, in his book Silsilat al-Hadith al-Sahiha, he classed it as Sahih. You will see there will be time when female slave will give birth to her master. One day Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was among his companions when Jibreel alayhi salatu wa sallam, the archangel, who came in the form of Bedouin, approached Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and asked him about Iman. The hadith is wrong, but at the end, Jibreel alayhi salatu wa sallam in the form of Bedouin asked him, فَأَخْبِرْنِي عَنِ السَّاعَةِ قَالَ مَا الْمَسْؤُولُ عَنْهَا بِأَعْلَمَ مِنَ السَّائِلِ قَالَ أَخْبِرْنِي عَنْ أَمَارَتِهَا قَالَ أَنْ تَلِدَ الْأَمَةُ رَبَّتَهَا وَأَنْ تَرَى الْحُفَاةَ الْعُرَاةَ الْعَالَةَ رِعَاةَ الشَّائِ يَتَطَوَّلُونَ فِي الْبُنْيَانِ. Ya Rasulullah, when is the hour? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam answered, saying that the one who is asking about this knows more about this matter. Jibreel alayhi salatu wa sallam said, inform me about the signs, the alamat and amaratia. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, it will be a female slave to give birth to her master. and for you to see the barefooted, naked, poor shepherds of sheep competing with one another to build high buildings. This hadith is recorded in Sahih Muslim. Abu Dawud rahmatullahi alayhi also recorded it, At-Tirmidhi also recorded it, An-Nasa'i also recorded it, and Ibn Majah rahmatullahi alayhi recorded it too. In a narration of Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, وَلَكِنْ سَأُحَدِّثُكَ عَنْ أَشْرَاطِهَا إِذَا وَلَدَتِ الْأَمَةُ رَبَّتَهَا فَذَاكَ مِنْ أَشْرَاطِهَا وَإِذَا كَانَتِ الْعُرَاةُ الْحُفَاةُ رُؤُوسُ النَّاسِ فَذَاكَ مِنْ أَشْرَاطِهَا وَإِذَا تَطَاوَلَ رِعَاءُ الْبَهْمِ فِي الْبُنْيَانِ فَذَاكَ مِنْ أَشْرَاطِهَا. But I will speak to you about its signs, confirming or supporting the hadith that I just mentioned. When a female slave gives birth to her master, then that is a form, that is one of the signs of the hour. And when the naked and poor ones become leaders over the people, then it is one of the signs. And when the shepherds of beasts compete with one another to build high buildings, then this is one of the signs of the hour. The Bedouin left. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, bring him back to me. When they went to get him, they did not find anything. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it was Jibreel alayhi salatu wasallam who came to teach the people about the affairs of their religion. This whole hadith, the conversation between Jibreel alayhi salatu wasallam and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was recorded in Sahih Muslim. Commenting on this hadith, Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali rahmatullahi alayhi said, the alamat of the hour of the sa'ah, the alamat al-sa'ah that are mentioned in this hadith have one common theme. Authority will be entrusted to those who do not deserve it, which is similar to what Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about the hour in another hadith. When the affair, meaning the leadership, will be entrusted to those who do not deserve it, then wait for the hour. So when naked people, when those who have no aura, when those who are barefooted, those who do not have shoes, get the leadership, then wait for the hour. And we are seeing it nowadays, this is nothing, but in the future it would be even worse, wal'iyaz billah. Those who are harsh in conversation, those who are really tough in talking or addressing people, meaning those who are from the shepherds, because when we see the shepherds, those who are from the Bedouin background, you will see them quite tough when they are talking. Due to the not socializing with the people, you would see them always talking in a harsh way. They would be rich. In addition to that, they would compete with building high-rise buildings. One of the other alamat al-sa'ah, al-sughra, will be an abundance of women coupled with paucity of men. There will be many women, and the number of men will be really low. Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu, who was the khadim of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as soon as Rasulullah made hijrah to Makkah, from Makkah to Medina, it was Anas radiallahu anhu that was given by his parents to be his khadim. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that إِنَّ مِنْ أَشْرَاطِ السَّاعَةِ أَنْ يَقِلَّ الْعِلْمِ وَيَكْثُرَ الْجَهَلْ وَيَفْشُوَ الزِّنَى وَيُشْرَبَ الْخَمَرْ وَيَقِلَّ الرِّجَالِ وَيَكْثُرَ النِّسَاءِ حَتَّى يَكُونَ لِخَمْسِينَ امْرَأَةَ الْقَيِّمُ الْوَاحِدِ. Indeed, from the alamat, from the signs of the hour, is that there will be little knowledge and widespread ignorance. Fornication or the zina will become so rampant, so prevalent. Alcohol will be consumed. Men will decrease in numbers and women will be plentiful. To an extent, it would be 50 women against one. A couple of years back, when I was going through the statistics of the United Nations, individually some countries have 9 women against one man. It is one of the Caribbean countries. Average 6 women against one man. We are just touching it. This whole hadith that is narrated here is regarding the Sahih al-Bukhari, Muslim, At-Tirmidhi, An-Nasa'i, and Ibn Majah. Abu Musa radiallahu anhu narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, لا يأتين على الناس زمان يطوف الرجل فيه بالصدقة من الذهب ثم لا يجد أحدا يأخذها منه ويرى الرجل الواحد يتبعه 40 امرأة يلذن به من قلة الرجال وكثرة النساء. There will come a time upon people when a man will go around with charity gold to give away, but will find no one, and no one will take from him the charity gold. And one of you will see that women, 40 women following the man, all of whom will be seeking his protection, since there will be few men and plentiful women. The meaning of the first hadith that was narrated is that single women will be guardian, caretaker, provider, single man will be guardian, caretaker and provider for 50 women. 1, 2, 3, or 4 of them will be his wives. The rest will be his female relatives, such as his sisters, mothers, aunts, grandmothers, and so on. It is one of the opinion. There is another hadith where Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiallahu anhu narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ بَيْنَ يَدَيْ سَاعَةً الْهَرْجِ. Verily, before the hour there will be al-harj. And the Sahaba radiallahu anhu majma'in asked, what is al-harj? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, al-qatl, inna laysa biqatlikum al-mushrikin, walakin qatlu ba'dikum ba'da, hatta yaqtula al-rajulu jara, wa yaqtula akhahu, wa yaqtula ammahu, wa yaqtula ibn ammi. Al-harj means the killing, massacre. Indeed, it will not be fighting and killing between you and the disbelievers and the kuffar. To the contrary, opposite to that, meaning killing each other. To a degree that a man will kill his neighbor, a man will kill his own brother, a man will kill his own uncle, and the man will kill his own cousin. Wal'iyad billah. When Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'in found out about al-Hajj, they asked, will we not have our minds intact? Meaning, will we not be in sanity? Will we not be in sound mind? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam answered, saying that, إِنَّهُ لَتُنْزَعُ الْعُقُولُ أَهْلِ ذَلِكَ الزَّمَانِ وَيَخْلُفُ لَهُ هَبَاءٌ مِّنَ النَّاسِ يَحْسِبُ أَكْثَرُهُمْ أَنَّهُمْ عَلَى شَيْءٍ وَلَيْسُوا عَلَى شَيْءٍ. Indeed, the minds of the people of those times, when this situation happens, the sanity will be lifted off, meaning people will be crazy. That time will leave behind the haba of people. Haba literally means the dust specks. In this context, it means the scum of mankind, meaning the lowest level of the mankind. Those who have no mercy when they are killing each other. Most of them will think that they are upon something, meaning that they are following what is right. Whereas in reality, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will lift their sanity away from their brain, from their head. And it will be really nothing. This whole hadith is recorded by Imam Ahmad rahmatullahi alayhi in his Musnad, as well as Ibn Majah rahmatullahi alayhi recorded it, and Shaykh al-Albani rahmatullahi alayhi classed it as sahih in his book Silsilatul Ahadith al-Sahihah. نفعني الله وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم وبهدي سيد المرسلين أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه وتوبوا إليه إنه هو التواب الرحيم إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله على إحسانه وشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشأنه وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله الداعي إلى رضوانه صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. Servants of Allah, one of the minor signs would be sharp decline in akhlaq, in manners. A hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that is narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قبل الساعة سنون خداعة يكذب فيها الصادق ويصدق فيها الكذوب ويخون فيها الأمير ويؤتمن فيها الخائن وينطق فيها الرويبضة. Indeed, before the hour, there are deceptive years. The truthful one will not be believed. The liar will be believed. And the trustworthy one will be accused of khiyana, betrayal. And the treacherous one will be trusted. And the ruwaybida will speak. Sahaba radiallahu anhu ajma'in asked, what is ruwaybida? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الرجل التافه يتكلم في أمر العامة. The man who is tafih, meaning insignificant, the one who did not have anything to do with the community, the one who did not have any manner, that person, the stupid person, will be talking about the matter of the community. He will speak on the affairs of the general people. He will be trusted to rule and he will speak in the name of the people. Wal'iyadh billah. This hadith is recorded by Imam Ahmad rahmatullahi alayhi in his Musnad. Ibn Majah rahmatullahi alayhi recorded it. Al-Hakim recorded it. Also, this hadith is classed as sahih by Shaykh al-Albani rahmatullahi alayhi. Previously, it was mentioned that there will be decline of knowledge and prevalence of al-jahl. But there is something else that we need to know. The hadith that were mentioned in the previous khutbah, you would see that the jahl, the ignorance, and al-harj pretty much interconnected. Ubaidullah and Abu Musa radiallahu anhum narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ بَيْنَ يَدَيْ السَّاعَةِ أَيَّامًا يُرْفَعُ فِيهَا الْعِلْمُ وَيَنْزِلُ فِيهَا الْجَهْلُ وَيَكْثِرُ فِيهَا الْهَرْجُ وَالْهَرْجُ الْقَتْلُ. Indeed, before the hour, there are days during which knowledge will be raised. One might ask how the knowledge will be raised. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives death to those who are knowledgeable. As a result, before those people died and people did not take knowledge or people did not benefit from those people, despite given the opportunity, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them the death, and the community that the scholars were living among will be led to ignorance. Wal'iyadh billah. Ignorance will descend and will become so widespread, and al-harj will increase in frequency. And al-harj means al-qatl, killing. Hadith is recorded in Sahih Bukhari, Sahih Muslim, Al-Tirmidhi, and Ibn Majah rahmatullahi alayhim, Ajma'in recorded this as well. Hudhayfa ibn al-Yaman radiallahu anhu narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يَدْرُسُ الْإِسْلَامُ كَمَا يَدْرُسُ وَشْيُ الثَّوْبِ حَتَّى لَا يُدْرَى مَا صِيَامُ وَلَا صَلَاتٌ وَلَا نُسُكٌ وَلَا صَدَقَةٌ وَلَا يُسْرَى عَلَى كِتَابِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ فِي لَيْلَةٍ فَلَا يَبْقَى فِي الْأَرْضِ مِنْهُ آيَةٌ وتبقى طوائف من الناس الشيخ الكبير والعجوز يقولون أدركنا آباءنا على هذه الكلمة لا إله إلا الله فنحن نقولها. There will be time when Islam will depart, the knowledge will depart and become lost, and all of its remnants will be erased. Just as the embroidery of a garment becomes obliterated with the passage of time. Until it will not be known what is fasting, masiyah, what is prayer, masalah, nusuk, generally speaking, acts of worship and ita'ah, meaning al-ibadah wal-ita'ah, and charity. In one night, in a single night, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-Qur'an al-Kareem, will leave. So that not a single verse, meaning not a one ayah, remains on the earth. But groups of people will remain. There will be old people. There will be old men and women that would say, أَدْرَكْنَا آبَاءَنَا عَلَى هَذِهِ الْكَلِمَةِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ فَنَحْنُ نَقُولُهَا. We were around when our parents used to say this phrase, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. That is why we say it. This hadith, Ibn Majah rahmatullahi alayhi recorded it. Al-Hakim recorded in his Mustadrak, and Shaykh al-Albani rahmatullah alayhi classed it as sahih in his book Silsilat al-Hadith al-Sahih. When we are given time, servants of Allah, benefit ourselves, not only just in the dunya, but also for the akhirah. No one should hesitate. Wallahi, there will be time that if you want to regret, that time will be taken away. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَ أَحَدَهُمُ الْمَوْتُ قَالَ رَبِّ ارْجِعُونَ. Until the death comes to one of you, the person will say, رَبِّ ارْجِعُونَ, O my Lord, return me. لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِي مَا أَشْرَكْتُ. So that I could do some of the good deeds that I did not do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in response to this, sharply he will say, كَلَّا, you shall never return. إِنَّهَا كَلِمَةٌ هُوَ قَائِلُهَا. It is just the words that he's saying, that he would like to go back and would do some good deeds. It is just words. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will mean nothing. وَمِنْ وَرَائِهِمْ بَرْزَخٌ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. When the person is buried, until the day of resurrection, he will be in the alam, or the world of barzakh. Let us not be someone like this that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran. Let us be from the forefront when it comes to the knowledge of al-Islam. Because the knowledge of al-Islam is so rich that the more you learn, the more you acquire knowledge, the more humble you will become. That is something we are missing, O servants of Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to come back to the Quran and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam upon the understanding of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'in. Allahumma ameen. Ibadallah, ya'lamu anna Allah amarakum bis salatu wa salam ala nabiyyi wa qala fi muhkam al-tanzil, inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabiyyi, ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu.